F-35 opponents have their say once again in Burlington. Good evening, everyone. I'm Stephanie Gorin.
And I'm George Mallet. Tomorrow, the Air Force is set to release a new environmental impact statement on the controversial jets. But tonight, opponents made their case in the sanctuary of Burlington's Unitarian Church. News Sense 6, News Channel 5's David Charnes just back from that well-attended event, joining us live in the newsroom. David.
George, opponents argued tonight that the F-35 program will hurt those awaiting its arrival, saying members of the military will see cuts to pay and benefits due to the jet's inflating price tag. Tonight they have a fighter jet designer on their side as Vermont's senior senator is speaking out.
You always find honest young guys in the Defense Department who'd rather have something that works than something that doesn't.
Pierre Spray co-designed the fighter jet now flying over Vermont, the F-16. He came in from D.C. to lend his voice to the hundreds of others gathered in Burlington Thursday to stop the newer F-35 from landing here.
When you look at the things that fail on this airplane, you realize this airplane has been designed by newbies. I mean, classic things that people have known how to do since the 1930s, like the tail hook and the fuel dump. I mean, these are not high-tech, cutting-edge stuff. They don't work on this airplane.
The plane opponents say would disturb 7,000 people living around the airport. It's also a program estimated to cost the government at least $400 billion. Senator Patrick Leahy, an F-35 supporter, says the plane is an honor for the Vermont National Guard.
I've heard a lot, and I heard one of the opponents say, "No, this is terrible. We got 5 minutes too much noise coming from this. 5 minutes for national defense."
But unnamed Pentagon officials told the Boston Globe last month data about basing the planes in South Burlington was, quote, fudged. That's put the powerful senator in the spotlight and has opponents scratching their heads.
But now they suddenly can't find anybody who's willing to say, yes, something was done wrong. Come on. I deal with facts.
Spray says if the government is going to spend upwards of $1 trillion, what they're paying for better be perfect.
My biggest issue with the program is that it doesn't work.
The final draft of the environmental impact statement laying out what the military believes the jet could do to the people living around the airport is due out tomorrow. Live in the newsroom tonight, I'm David Charnes, News Channel 5 Nightcast.